Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome back to the action-packed finals hall here in Granada, Spain, for the last final of Rifle and Pistol, and it's going to be 10-meter air pistol men. I'm Hillary Russell, and it's been a great time here. We've seen amazing scores taking place, and we're going to find out today who's going to be on the highest step of the podium for 10-meter air pistol men. Just keep in mind, of the new finals format, we have the top 8 athletes who, after qualifications, enter into the final where their qualification scores are erased and all start with 0. 10-meter air pistol men consists of 2 series of 3 shots, which the athletes have 150 seconds for each series to shoot. This is followed by single shots to be shot within 50 seconds. After the 8th shot, the athlete with the lowest score is eliminated. This goes on to the 18th shot, where we have our bronze medalists, and after the 20th, we have our gold and silver medalists. We've got some very, very talented shooters here today, and it will just be a matter of time to find out who's going to be on the podium. But in fact, we do have one gentleman who has never competed in a World Cup before, going up against some incredible talent, like I was saying before. Actually, there he is right now, from Italy. Last name, Amore. All week long, we've been seeing scores that have just been incredibly high, and at the last minute, you think you know who's going to be winning the gold medal, and the last shot determines it, and all of a sudden, everything changes. The standings change, and it's been adding some incredible excitement to the finals here in the finals hall. And as you know, it's a combined World Cup between rifle, pistol, and shotgun. We still have 2 more finals that will be coming up, and that will be Skeet Women this evening at 8 o'clock, and tomorrow Skeet Men at 7:30 in the evening. They've got about 10 more seconds before they're going to turn around and face us, and we'll get a chance to meet these very talented athletes. So really, some Olympic Games medalists going up against someone like Amore that has no experience in a World Cup before.
Ladies and gentlemen, the organizing committee of the ISSF World Cup Granada 2013 and the International Shooting Sport Federation welcome you to the shooting range, the Arte Tiro Olimpico Juan Carlos Primero. The finals competition for the 10-meter air pistol men's event will now begin. It's my pleasure to present to you the finals.
On firing point H, representing Serbia, we have Dmitri Gurgic. He's never won a medal in the World Cup before, so I'm sure he's very hungry to go ahead and do that. On firing point G, representing Japan, we have Tomoyuki Matsuda, very talented, talented young man, and had a great season 2011-2010. On firing point F, representing Kazakhstan, we have Rashid Yunusmatov, also a very talented athlete. On firing point E, representing the Republic of Korea, we have Yongho Jin. He's just an amazing, amazing shooter. He was in a final earlier this week and ended up with 11 points above all the other shooters. On firing point D, representing Spain, we have Pablo Carrera. And he's got all of his support here, firing on his own home turf. And you can tell the people love him. On firing point C, representing the Russian Federation, we have Vladimir Isakov. This is another very, very experienced veteran shooter. On firing point B, representing the Ukraine, we have Oli Omelchuk. And in fact, he just came off of Fort Benning winning the silver. And on to the new face that we've got here. We have, on firing point A, representing Italy, Andrea Amore. So it's his debut for Andrea, and so we'll have to see how this goes for him. He did score the highest score during the qualifications. He had a one-point advantage over Omelchuk, and really just amazing, amazing shooting. Got a very, very rowdy crowd here. And in fact, we had a great time before this final started as the Spanish people here led us to a great, great dance and song. So we're going to get the first series going now. And just remember, this consists of two series of three shots, which the athletes have 150 seconds for each series to shoot. And then we'll be going into the single shots. You know, it'd be very interesting to know what's going through Amore's head right now. All these other gentlemen, of course, have had an experience in a World Cup before. Except for Gurgic, he has never made it into a final round of a World Cup. Actually, I'm mistaken there. He did in Shangwang in 2011. He ended up finishing off in eighth place. Okay, so they've just given the command to load for the first competition series. And they've been given the command to start. Looks like Gurgic is just taking his time here. It's really great to see a different Serbian coming into the finals. You know, they've got a very, very strong team. And starting off with a 9.4 for Gurgic. For Carrera. And we still have 110 seconds before the series is over. Amore starting off with a 10.4. And that's coming up a 9.6 there. Omelchuk with the 9.2. He started off quite strong with a 10.3. Let's see if he can get back into the 10 ring. Carrera shooting in the 9 ring. Either he's feeling the pressure of shooting on his own home turf, or it's working for him. We'll have to find out and see. Jin just having an incredible season. He's such a talented man. Finishing off with a 10.9. Like I said, he finished off in first place after 50-meter pistol then, and he just shot an incredible final, finishing off with 11-point lead over the others. Matsuda's is not quite his style here, shooting in the eighth ring. Let's take a look now at the standings after the first series. We have Jin holding on to first place by 1 point over Amore. Gurgic in third place, 0.6 of a point behind. And Carrera in fourth, only 0.4 of a point. Everybody is really, really tight, just 0.1 of a point separating everybody, except for Matsuda, who had that really hard start there. He is 1.3 of a point behind Inusmatov. We've got another series to go before we go into single shots. Like I was saying, this Jin has just been on a roll lately. Start. with just such concentration. He has nothing to cover up his eye. And you could tell that was a good shot. No movement whatsoever. And again now onto Amore. He's starting off with a 9.9. He's got to get it into that 10 ring. Just a little bit shaky there. 9.8. Gergic starting off with an 8.6. With a 10.4. And we've got Carrera with a 10.3. Taking some good relaxing breaths of air, trying to get himself in the zone here. He's looking quite stable. 8.7 for Carrera. We're seeing quite a few shots here in the eights, actually. It's surprising also for Jin, who shot in the eight ring. So let's take a look now at what's happening here. We've got Matsuda, who's moved up the scoreboard now, tied up with Isakov. We've got Amore now in first place. He has overtaken Jin. He's 0.4 of a point over Jin. Gergic is 1.2 of a point behind Jin. Omelchuk only 0.2 of a point behind. It is really, really tight right now to see what's going to happen and who is going to be eliminated. So we've got single shots here. We're going to be going two shots. Then we're going to find out who is going to be eliminated. It's going to be a tough call. We have Unismatov holding on to eighth place right now, but only 0.2 of a point behind Isakov and Matsuda, who are tied up for sixth place. And they're only 0.1 of a point behind Carrera. So really, it's anybody's game right now with the scores that are so tight like this. But in the meantime, let's just focus in and take a look at what can happen here with Unismatov. His time for the very right moment and finishes off with a 10.0. Matsuda with a 9.9. So let's just take a look now. We still have Amore in first place over Jin because they both shot a 10.6. Gergic is in third place, tied up with Omelchuk right now. And only 0.8 of a point behind, we've got Carrera. Things have moved around. We've got Isakov now, who is a 0.5 point behind Unismatov and is in eighth place. So we're going to have to take a look on Isakov, see if he can shoot really, really strong, really deep, and overtake Unismatov. Unismatov is only 0.1 of a point behind Matsuda. So let's take a look here between Matsuda, Unismatov, and Isakov and see how this goes. Last shot for Isakov. He's coming off of a 9.3 with a 10.4. Unismatov with a 9.1. This is probably going to change things around here. Unbelievable shooting. We have Amore who just shot a perfect 10.9. So unfortunately, we're going to have to say goodbye to Rashid Unismatov. He put up a good fight, but that 9.1 just knocked him out of the standings over Isakov. So let's just take a look here. Amore, unbelievable. A 10.9 has moved him up 1.6 tenths of a point over Jin. Omelchuk is now in third place, 1.1 tenths of a point behind Jin. And it's Gurgic, 3 tenths of a point behind Omelchuk. And Matsuda, everybody else is so incredibly tight. But we're going to have to take a look at Isakov and follow his shooting, as well as Carrera. There's 7 tenths of a point separating Isakov from Carrera. And in 2 shots, we'll know who's going to finish off in 7th place. Nine for Isakov. I'm sorry, that was a 9.0 for Carrera. And Jin with a 10.1. It was Amori who had the highest score this time with a 10.5. Fantastic shooting. He has now has a 2-point lead over Jin. Gurgic in third place, 1 point behind Jin. Matsuda is on his heels, only 6 tenths of a point behind. Now it's Isakov that we're going to have to focus in now. He's only 1 tenth of a point behind Carrera. And so it's going to be a tight fight now to find out who's going to stay in, who's going to be eliminated between Pablo Carrera and Vladimir Isakov. Two men are standing neck to neck here on the firing line. We have Carrera coming off of that 9.0. .3 for Isakov. And a 10.2 for Carrera. We are going to have to go into a shoot-off now, a three-way shoot-off, to find out who is going to be eliminated between Carrera, Isakov, and Omelchuk. You don't often see this happening, but this is amazing, a three-way tie. So they're just getting the commands right now that they only these three gentlemen can shoot. This is for the shoot-off. They're putting some very, very excitement into this final. Omelchuk, Isakov, and Carrera. .5 for Carrera. And the crowd is very, very excited about this. We're going to have Isakov and Carrera that will be staying in. Unfortunately, we are going to have to say goodbye to Ole Omelchuk. He missed it by 1 tenth of a point over Isakov. Carrera with a 10.5 is staying in the game here, out of doubt. Isakov is now in 6th place. So now we are going to be going for 5th place here. We've got Carrera and Isakov tied up in 5th place. Amore is in 1st place by 1.4 tenths of a point over Jin. And a 10.1. Oh, and a perfect 10.9 for Carrera, and the crowd is so happy about that. One more shot to find out who is going to be finishing off in 6th place, and it's Vladimir Isakov who's in the hot spot once again. 10.9 for Carrera has really saved him here. He is now only 2 tenths of a point behind Matsuda, who is holding on to 4th place. Amori has lost a little bit of his lead. He is now 8 tenths of a point ahead of Jin. And we know that Jim can really lay it on strong. So it's Isikov that we got to watch over right now. 0.8 of a point he is behind Carrera. And of course, if Carrera can keep on nailing them like he just did with a 10.9, he will be on the top without a doubt. .7 for Carrera and a 9.8 for Isikov. And it's enough for Carrera. Finishing off in fifth place, we have Vladimir Isikov. So let's just take a look at things and what's going on here. We have got Amore still in first place by 1 point. And it's Pablo Carrera, 0.7 of a point behind Matsuda. We've got two shots to go to see if Carrera can stay in this fight and keep on moving up the scoreboard. Matsuda, 0.7 of a point ahead of Carrera. .9 He's not at all happy with that. 10.3 for Carrera. That's going to help out his situation right now. And in fact, we've got Amore with a 10.1. 10.3 was the highest score, and that was for Carrera. He is now only 1/10 of a point behind Matsuda, and Matsuda is only 1/10 of a point behind Gergic. Amore is holding on to first place by 1.3 of a point, and Gergic is 3 points behind Jin. Carrera, 1/10 of a point. He made up a great, great stride there. So it's really between Carrera, Matsuda, and Gergic. The pressure's on, and let's see if Carrera can just keep on putting on the pressure. .10 for Carrera and a .9 for Gergic. .10 for Matsuda. And unfortunately, that 9.5 is going to change things around. It saved Carrera. We're going to have to say goodbye for Dmitry Gergic. Fifth place, he ends up. And Amore just keeps on moving ahead, having more 10ths of a point lead. He's got 2 points ahead of Jin now. Matsuda, 2.23 of a point behind Jin. And Carrera is in fourth place. He is a half a point behind Matsuda. This is a tough shot here. This is one that the next two shots are kind of tough here, because this is what's going for who's going home on the podium and who's not going home, what's going home in fourth place. Again, on to Amore. He's showing some amazing talent today. .9 for Amore. Oh, and an 8.7. Sorry, 10.7 for Jin. He has put the pressure on big time. We've got Carrera, who came off of an 8.7 there. He's now 1.1 of a point behind Matsuda. But now Jin has got an advantage here. He's only 3/10 of a point now behind Amore. So let's focus in again on Carrera. He is 1.1 of a point behind Matsuda, and that's going to be very, very hard to make up. Matsuda, who's got a lot of experience, really great guy. finishes off with a 9.6. And a 9.2 for Carrera is just not going to do it. And things are changing around big time. In the fourth place, we are going to have to say goodbye to Pablo Carrera. He put up a very, very good fight. The crowd loves him without a doubt. And we've got Jin, who's now overtaken Amore. Amore shot at 8.3 to finish off those last two series. So we've got Jin once again in the lead. He is 1.5 points ahead of Amore. Matsuda is down 2.7 tenths of a point behind Amore. And we've got two more shots to find out who will be going home with the bronze medal. And unless something really dramatic happens, it's going to be Matsuda. Oh, 7.6. He's not going to be able to get it back, unfortunately. Let's take a look at Jin now. Jin with a 10.1, but Amore is putting on the heat with a 10.8. One more shot to go to find out who's going to be with the bronze, and it will definitely be Matsuda. Again, Jin is in the lead, but he's lost his great advantage. He is in the lead by 8 tenths of a point. Almost 6 points behind Amore. We've got Matsuda here. That 7.6 really dropped him right down. We all know that he's got it in him to shoot like a star, without a doubt. .10 for Matsuda to finish off. Whoa. And we've got Jin, who shot a 9.7. And an 8.0 for Amore. So let's just take a look here. We are going to have to say goodbye, unfortunately, to Matsuda from Japan. Tomoyuki Matsuda, bronze medalist today. He put up a good fight. Just a couple shots here that got away from him. We've got Jin now with 2.5 points over Amore. And two shots to go to see who's going to be on the highest up of the podium. And I truly believe that we can take a look at Jin. He has been just shooting insanely well lately. Back on now to Amore. Amore just focusing in there. 9.8 for both of them. Jin and Amore, 2.5 tenths of a point separating the two. Nothing has changed there. This is our final competition shot, and I have a feeling that is pretty much wrapped up at this point for Jin. I have to say, though, Amore has done an unbelievably great job to get into the final. Never has been in a World Cup before, and is ending up on the podium. He was holding on to first for quite a long time here in today's final. But let's focus in now on Jin. 10.1. And the silver will go to Amore. And in fact, here we go. Let's see. Here he is, our gold medalist, Jongho Jin from the Republic of Korea, winning once again a gold medal here during our time in Granada. And our silver medalist today, first time on the podium, we have Andrea Amore. Really, really great shooting by Andrea. He's got a lot of people in the stands there that are rooting for him. So I just ask everybody to stay tuned in. Let's move it on over to the shotgun range later on this evening, 8 o'clock for Skeet Woman.
Your gold medalist, representing the Republic of Korea, John Ojin. Ladies and gentlemen.